when the animals look around the animal kingdom, they don't see any, there's no nice tits, bro. I've been to the zoo, dude. You know what I'm saying? Every now and then, maybe you see something that's got a nice little baby bag hanging off.
Yeah, some of those gorillas are banging, though, Doug. Some of the asses on the baboons that get you going. You feel me?
No, keep going, bud.
Gang, gang.
Buzz, buzz.
Back off my broccolini.
Get your life together.
It is.
Don't touch me, bro.
I'm not touching you, dude.
You look like Carl Lentz if he cheated on his wife with a buffet.
Look like Carl Lentz if I was fucking cheating on my girl at Chili's.
Yeah, yeah. Dude, you look like a hitman for Golden Corral, bro. That's what you look like.
Bro.
Oh, it's a dessert.
Bro, what the fuck are you wearing, dude? And why is it on button solo? Dude, you look like the only chick that got kicked out of the Charles Manson family for being too negative.
Okay, bro, I respect that, dude.
Dude, you look like you're in the deleted scenes of fucking Tiger King. You look like Joe Exotic's gayest boyfriend in the deleted scenes.
Bro, you look like you comb your hair with Joe Rogan's dick, bro.
Dude, you look like you give Joe Rogan massages in his fucking sauna.
Yeah, oh no, that's true. I look like I sneak into his sleep in the middle of the night and give him a massage.
Just you look like asleep, you look like when he's in a sauna, you poke your head and go, "You need any water? I got water out here."
Yeah. Oh, you order something?
Do you need some jerky? Did you say elk?
Dude, I look like a guy that can make jerky in his bowels, dude. I look fucking. Bro, I look like one of Lyle Lovett's Christmas ornaments today. I look not good.
Dude, you look like you got kicked out of Chuck E. Cheese for staring at the mouse too long.
Man, where'd he learn to play guitar like that?
Man, that guy's creeping me out with the seven buttons unbuttoned on his fucking denim shirt staring at me.
Gang, baby. I got that solid gold on, baby. It's 18 karat or something, 80 karat.
You got down the streets of Nashville?
Nah, man, I got, for Christmas, I got my whole family gold chains. I got everybody golded up.
Oh, damn. Took a page out of DaBaby.
You know what happened, baby. Everybody got golded up, bro. I rolled right into Kohl's, bro.
Hell yeah. That two-for-one deal, them fake chains, everybody's neck's going to be green in Nashville.
Hey, look, bro, that's how it is, man. I'm that green neck family, bro. We got Grinch neck over at our house, dog.
Get them Grinch vibes.
Dude, everybody got chains. My nephews, my mom, everybody got chained up. We put it on them, bro. And this is real, I think, from Italy.
We'll see. When you fly back to LA, I'll tell you if that shit's real. You don't want to go chain for chain, son. You don't go chain for chain, daddy.
Nah. I don't. You're right, man. I don't have, I mean, my drip's different, dude. I just got these new boots today. I sent you that picture.
Dog, that picture's swaggy.
Yeah, that sounds good, man. I got these Rujo boots, same as Bryce Mitchell.
You look like you rode Bryce Mitchell in the studio today. Them boots are swaggy and gay.
Oh, yeah, dude. I look like somebody that drinks Bryce Mitchell's sweat. Hey, Bryce, gonna get a straw?
I'm all set on liquid IV today.
I'm taking it straight off the branch.
Taking it straight off the Mitchell.
Yeah, let's get into it, man. Did you guys have a good Christmas? I didn't even ask you, though.
Yeah, dog, it was cool. Cool for the kiddos, you know? Gifts on gifts.
Yeah, would you get that little dime of mine over there, huh?
Oh, I got him a little electric book. He can just push on the buttons, you know, because he can't read.
Oh, damn. Wonder what parent he got that from.
Yeah, it was just I just re-gifted it. I just wrapped my book and gave it to him. It's a Charles Manson one, but he'll get the idea.
Hey. Yeah, dude, I do look like every stunt double from that Charles Manson movie.
Yeah, you do, dog. You kicked out of the Manson family.
Yes, sir. Oh, this shirt has a lot of starch in it, too.
Oh, that shirt is swaggy. That's that G-star, that gay star.
Yeah, I could barely even hitchhike. I could barely get my thumb up higher than that.
So I'm going to pick you up, though.
This heavy star.
That's that lot lizard jersey there.
Uncle Buck will pick me up. Remember that movie, Uncle Buck?
Great movie.
Glad I brought it up.
God, me too, dog. That made my day. Uncle Buck.
And he was up in Wisconsin, wasn't he, Nick?
I sadly haven't seen that. Is it Wisconsin? Unreal. I feel like I should know that.
You've never seen Uncle Buck?
I haven't. My sisters will always watch it, and it was like I was too young, and I was just like, I hate the movies you guys are watching, so I didn't want to watch Uncle Buck for some reason.
Oh, you fucked up.
I've heard it's a classic.
Fuck yeah. He comes in that station wagon, remember, with the chainsaw? Because that girl's dating that dude out in the forest, and they're smoking and drinking.
Dude, remember that station wagon has that like that reverb on it where it backfired?
Yeah, it was all loud, the big shots. Remember, he was always trying to fuck that girl in the crib? She was always coming over, his main chick. And then the chick across, the next door neighbor was always trying to slang them titties at him.
Oh, he used to fuck, man. Yeah. How long were you, John Candy?
How long were you going to pretend John Candy was pulling all those hoes, though? That's how you know it was the movie.
Dude, he used to fuck. I heard.
Yeah, I heard that.
Oh, I heard that guy could fuck a lot.
Sir, you know sir, fuck a lot, Doug.
Some people say that's what killed him.
Yeah, that's true. He did pass away.
Sir, fuck a lot, bro. Baby got buck, 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 buck. Baby got Uncle Bucked, dog. Hey, what'd y'all do over there in Wisconsin, Nick? You guys do Christmas or what?
You went
you guys
home?
Started
I didn't. I was planning on it. My brother-in-law got COVID like December 18th, and they had a quarantine.
Wow.
Everybody's fine, but my grandma's 83, so.
Play it safe.
Play it safe, I guess. But, like, she's really sad. Her brother just passed away.
From COVID?
No, just he's old. And he might have had COVID. Who knows? He was, like, on dialysis already. But so didn't go back, but we're going to surprise her in a couple weeks, and hopefully she doesn't die.
So what'd you do?
Just sat at home with the girlfriend. She made a nice honey-baked Christmas ham. And
ooh.
We watched, like, 4 hours of Shark Tank. It was a pretty good time.
Ooh.
Y'all right. Must be rich, bro.
Something you had the best Christmas.
It wasn't bad, to be honest.
You got that ham, brother. I'll say this.
A little ham
and
suck.
Do not surprise your grandparent. That is a
that's smart.
Yeah, you're basically at that point. You're just basically like you're like a bathtub with no grip on it, dude. You were going.
Yeah, man.
That is very dangerous for a senior, bro.
That's a great point. Honestly, I did it freshman year of college. I came home for a weekend, didn't tell her, and I was home when she got home. And that week, my dog had to be put down, and she hadn't told me because she was too sad about it.
And
she was like, what are you doing home? And she like started yelling at me. She got all emotional, and I went in the shower and cried.
God damn, that sounds terrible.
So a bunch of happy stories.
You're
going to
surprise her again and have your Asian girlfriend there? Yeah. I mean, that's a terrible idea, man.
She's already seen the Asian girlfriend, so.
There's nothing wrong. And is that the first Asian that she's ever like really spent time with?
There's a lot of Hmong people in La Crosse, Wisconsin.
Doesn't mean she comes across them, though.
Yeah, true. Yeah, definitely, I guess, up close and personal. Possibly future in-law.
And shout out to the Hmong girl. I met a girl up in Madison, Wisconsin one time at a comedy show.
Yeah, that's Hmong. A lie.
No, that's where they hang out.
No, bro, him meeting this girl.
It was an arranged meeting, okay?
You mean a guy with long hair, Theo?
What you talking about?
Great
she was
set,
full
brother.
Hmong. This girl was about 200% Hmong. Yeah. And, bro, she wanted me to go out to lunch with her the next day. She brought her whole family to lunch,
hell
bro.
Yeah. And you had to pay for all of them?
Yeah. She brought her cousin, grandparent,
fuck
mom.
Yeah.
I was like, what is good? Like, I didn't know the culture, what it is. And so they munged me with the bill. That's for sure, dude. They munged me with about $200 worth of damn, where'd we go eat?
Would you guys go
Pot
Shoney's?
Bellies. No, Potbelly's choice sandwiches.
Oh, that's not too bad. Just a few sandwiches. Quit your crying, dog.
Bro, it was 11 people.
Oh.
How many egg rolls did they sell you? That's their business.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, they have one up their sleeve every now and then. They have the old grandpa who'll reach my ear and pull out a little egg roll, bro.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
They do it like that, bro. They'll hide one. Brennan will hide one in his butt, that's for sure.
All right, what do you got, Nick? Let's start this bitch up.
Yeah, so I didn't go back to Wisconsin because it was cold. There would have been a lot of snow. But this guy, Dan, he's in a place where there's a lot of snow. So let's kick it off with a King It or Sting It.
Hey, Brandon. Hey, Theo. This is Dan in Tampa, Florida. And I've lived most of my life in Connecticut, and recently I've been having my friends reach out to me crying about all the snow they get up there. And got me thinking of maybe there's some creative ways to get rid of the snow. Brendan, I know you're from Colorado, so I'm sure you've shoveled your share of snow. And my question is, boys, king it or sting it? Flamethrow in your driveway. Gang, gang, buzz, buzz.
Oh, damn, daddy. That is gangster.
Bro, that is savage.
It's doing the goddamn job, though.
100%. How is this guy the first guy to think of this?
I bet you if Elon Musk took his ass to Aspen, he'd be doing the same shit.
Elon Mustard, dude. That guy's bullshit, I think.
You're not buying Elon Musk? You're not an Elon Musk fan?
Look, I'm getting a Tesla truck. I will admit it. But
you would get a Tesla truck.
Did you pay to get on the wait list?
They're going to be dope. I'm considering paying. I have the tab open on my web on my computer.
Oh, you're talking about the truck. I'm thinking of the SUV. You're talking about the truck. The square thing? That'd be dope. Dude. That ain't for you. That ain't for you, bro.
Comes with a hot bitch in the back.
No, it comes with a handsome dude in the back.
Hey, dude. I don't know that guy. Get out of here, man. What's your name?
What's your name? Yeah, that thing is dope.
What do you think? King it or sting it, man? I say, look, if this is this neighborhood Bowser, this dude is welcome to burn down the whole fucking neighborhood if he wants, bro. You can use this to clean your driveway. You can use this to, if your kid sees you out there melting the damn yard, bro, you're like somebody that gives like side hustles in Final Fantasy, bro. I think you've made it at that point.
Legend. This fucking Fahrenheit 451 neighbor, this would be sick, bro. Yeah. This shit would be dope. He's also like the dude off Running Man, if you remember that super 80s movie with Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Running Man, dude? Yeah, no thanks, bro. I'm into chicks.
Yeah, whatever. Keep lying to yourself.
I'm not lying to myself, dude. I just read in my diary yesterday that I am straight, you idiot.
Your outfit says different, son.
Yeah, this isn't my outfit, dude. I borrowed this from somebody who was actually having a really tough day, Brendan.
90%. Who would sting it? Who the fuck would sting a flamethrower? There's nothing more badass than a flamethrower. The only thing that make it more badass is throwing grenades up in that bitch.
Yeah, dude. Now we're talking, bro. Snow grenades, bro.
Yeah, Doug. Yeah. From L.A. bro, to Nashville, son. Denim bros. Yeah, dude. Denim bros.
Don't do it again.
Denim bros.
Don't do it again. He did it.
So, yeah, 90%.
But, dude, yeah, if you had a grenade, I'm sorry, Nick, if you had a grenade that could eliminate the snow in your yard, also, once you do the yard, you can go straight and barbecue some meat. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't stop right there.
That's what I'm saying. Keep that bitch going. Do your neighbor's lawn. Get a nice brisket out there. Fucking tan up your girl with the flames, bro.
Yeah, dude, yeah.
Tan up them cheeks if you want. Whatever you want to do, bro.
That's the move. Do your neighbors. I've never been more appreciative than when the neighbor with the snowblower comes and does yours, and dude, you wake up and it's done.
Dude, little fact about my dad and snowblowers. They're real triggering for the man, because when he was 17, he had a snowblowing business, and the snowblower got stuck, and my father was like, oh, you know what? It's stuck. I'm going to stick my hand in there and unstick it. And it cut off three of his fingers. So my papa's hand, they saved two of them. My papa's hand's like this. I'll have him send a picture of his hand to us for the video. His hand's like this. So these two fingers have fake knuckles, and this one's missing it.
Dude, are you serious?
Yeah, swear to God.
How is that the first time we've heard that?
I mean, we've never talked about snowblowers before. It's not, you know, we're usually in L.A.
Bro, this whole time, you've been telling us about all this other shit, fat, this and this. I can't read, but you fucking forgot to tell us.
Yeah, my dad, your only dad has four fingers, son.
Your father is missing 10% of his fucking grip tactic?
Yeah, bro. And he lifts like a motherfucker, but he has to lift with gloves on because his grip's not great. But he's like a Ninja Turtle. These four are strong as fuck.
Like a sloth.
Dog, meet my dad at 215, bro. You think you're badass training that bullshit jiu-jitsu out there in Nashville. Why don't you meet my dad at 215, see what the fuck's up with his four fingers, son?
I'll put your dad in that hard scarf, boy.
Come get it, bro.
Hush, little baby, don't say. You need to get some help, man.
I need help?
Yeah, I've just been seeing you do stuff. I've been seeing you Sometimes I see you sitting out in your car and you're just having all those eating chocolates or eating like a little. I see you having that Lunchable.
Dude, I need to talk to someone, but I'm surrounded by idiots. Do you have like any real professional help I could get?
Thankfully, I do, Brendan.
Oh, thank God.
What I'm talking today about is BetterHelp.com, man. Now, BetterHelp is a real service, you know, and sometimes you see a buddy, he don't know what he's doing. He's hitchhiking, you know, he's drinking at noon, and he quit work, you know, and he didn't even have a job. But now times are changing for him, and what I'm saying is there's a broad range of expertise available.
Yeah.
Right now.
Yep. It's not a crisis line. It's not self-help. It's professional counseling done securely online. Listen, you can start communicating in under 48 hours, all right? It's available worldwide, baby. World freaking wide. It's more affordable than traditional offline counseling, and financial aid is also available. BetterHelp wants you to start living a happier life right now. Visit their website, read their testimonials, all right? They got a ton of them. Visit betterhelp.com/cats. That's BetterHelp, H-E-L-P, .com/cats. And so many people are doing it. They're hiring a bunch of additional counselors in all 50 states. Special offer for the King of the Sting listeners. Get 10% off your first month at betterhelp.com/cats.
And here's how you know if you need help. If you think you might need help, check it out. You know, like if you think you keep thinking about the same stuff and it doesn't make you feel good, check it out.
It's science, dude. Quit talking to your friends. Talk to a professional.
Yeah, quit talking to your friends or idiots. Your friend has 9 fingers, dude.
Yeah. Or at least his dad does.
But even so, his dad, you're getting suggestions from somebody whose dad has 9 fingers.
It's not good.
Yeah, if you're listening to this podcast for any sort of help, do not do that. Go to betterhelp.com/KATS.
Oh, dude,
dog, you look like a fucking lunch lady at a funeral, dude. That's what I want to say right now, bro.
Well, bro, your hair's looking extra sick, though, dog. And listen, 2021, you don't want to be the bald dude, man. You don't want to be missing your hair in 2021. You can do something about it, man, with Hims. I'm talking 4 Hims. And guess what? 66% of men start to lose their hair by 35. Keep what you got.
I take it in the morning. I take it in the morning, B.
Oh, do you? I thought, dude, your hair's looking extra frosty and thick right now. It's 4hims.com, one-stop shop for hair loss, skincare, sexual wellness for the bros. All right?
Well, don't hit on me, dog. Don't hit on me. I just dyed it as well today.
Oh, I knew something was going on, Daddy.
Yeah, it looks darker, huh?
Yeah, man. It looks long down the back.
You can't tell. Oh, yeah. That's for the ladies.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying is this, man, a lot of men, they dick ain't right. Their head ain't right. You see a man, is you can't see it, you know. He look like he don't know nothing about his dick, and his head don't know what's up.
Yep.
And that's the kind of man you want to get him this. You want to get him this treat. It's basically when you give a dog a treat for vitamins. It's like that, but for a man, and they need it every day.
Every day.
It's a one-stop shop for hair loss, skin care, and sexual wellness, as Brendan said. This ain't no snake oil. Okay, this ain't no gas station wiener uppers, and you know I'm on them. This
dude.
Is no more awkward. I am. I've taken them for years, man. They're always called like buzzer, you know, or stinger.
Stinger.
And it has like 9 bees stinging a woman. It's like, bro, that looks illegal. Okay. What I'm saying is, Hims is giving you their best offer yet. If you're not happy with your results after 90 days, Hims will give you a full refund. Look. You have nothing to lose.
Nothing.
Listeners get their first absolutely free. Go to 4hims.com/KATS. That's 4hims.com/KATS. B, hit them with a disclaimer.
Prescription products require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if the prescription is appropriate. Restrictions apply. See website for full details, important safety information. Remember, that's 4hims.com/CATS.
I'll tell you this, bro. I'm going to match you here, B, because this is what's crazy, man, and I didn't know this. My dad, when he was young, was playing hide and go seek with his brothers, not blacks, he had 2 brothers that both died.
Sure.
But when they were alive, they were playing hide and go seek. And one of them slammed his finger off.
Oh, really? Cut it. So your dad's missing that one too?
Yeah.
What's the fucking chances of that, bro?
Bro, and what are the chances of this episode not being named Nine Finger Dad?
For real.
Bro, I swear to God, man, my whole life, my dad was missing.
Yeah, me too. I'll ask my dad to take a picture of his hand. He's kind of self-conscious about it, but I bet I can get a picture at him. He hates me, but I'll make sure we get a cool picture.
Get that bitch out, dude. Yeah, dude, have him get that. He had that. Have you ever considered? That's crazy that both of our dads are missing a finger.
Nuts.
Nick, can you look up what percentage of people are missing a finger?
I mean, probably 1%, less than 1%, right?
I don't know. I'm trying to think. If I shake somebody's hand, I do a little bit of recon while I'm down there, and I feel to see, make sure they what.
I thought it was weird my entire fucking childhood. My dad was always, you know, just that nub, son.
Oh, that nub's crazy. And my dad used to do this thing when we were kids. He'd have us go look for his finger in the yard when we didn't know any better.
Yep, same shit. My dad would go, oh, go find my finger. Hours looking for that bitch.
Yeah. And then he'd yell out every now and then. He'd get drunk and he'd be like, it's in your mom. And we'd all be like, hey, what's going on?
But every time my dad comes to my house, my son would go, hey, he'll go, hey, grandpa, remember you're missing a finger? My dad's like, yeah, dude. Yeah, man, still not here. Every time he sees him, grandpa, remember you're missing a finger? I love it. I fucking love it.
I got some numbers for you.
What do you got, Doug?
In 1996, so this is a really old study, 4.9 people per 1,000, so 0.49%, were missing some sort of limb. That could be finger, that could be whole arm, but some sort of limb.
So how much is that for Brendan?
0.5%.
Hey,
and how much is that?
Hey, if you have to miss a finger or toe, what are you picking? I'm picking toe, bro.
I don't know what. Yeah, toe you can hide it. Yeah, toe doesn't care. Toe. I don't know if that's even a fair trade off, bro. Toe ain't shit, bro.
You say that, but you miss that pinky or that big toe, you'd be walking already fucked up than you already are now.
Ooh, that big one would be tough, bro.
That big
one. I don't need the toes. Now I got these boots. I don't even need any toes. You freak.
I love how you have headphones on. You look like the gayest DJ in Reno right now.
One more time. We're going to celebrate. All right. Oh, yeah. Get the trip.
People are like, this is a funeral, man. Get it together.
This is a funeral, like, oh, man.
Should we move on to another King It or Sting It?
Yeah, bring it.
We got this guy.
Let's do it. Did we help that last guy? What did he say? Yeah, dude, look.
Flamethrower all
day.
Torch
the whole damn neighborhood, bro. Get biblical. Burn a damn bush down. Who gives a damn?
Fuck yeah. And look into grenades for me and send us a video.
Oh, beautiful.
What's this meth head talking about?
Hey, what's up, guys? This is Kyler from Stanford, Texas. I got a King of Stinger for y'all. Homemade Christmas gifts.
Ooh.
Let me know what y'all think. Gang, gang, buzz.
You got a skill like that, king it all day. If you're handy with them tools, make it. Make it, bro. But if you're not, like, I don't want Theo to give me some fucking stuffed hamster for Christmas. You know what I'm saying? I need that real gift from Theo. But if you got some skills, build that shit. Nothing better, son. Something you can't buy in the store? That'd be sick. Mm-hmm.
Look, I commend what you're doing there, brother, because I'm saying this, especially at a time when there's only 7 companies left, man. Yep. There's like Delta Airlines, Amazon, Hibachi,
Tesla,
Jimmy John, Tesla, that's it. So, you know, to be doing something unique, that's going to speak volumes if you really can make something legit. I love it. It looked like you had a little climbing wall there for your son, and that's dangerous if it's a crib, if you still have a crib child. Because you don't want them teaching to sneak out, you know, to get bit by a rat or something like on that that cartoon. But
you talking about Ratatouille?
Dude, I remember. I don't think it's it.
That's that. You know, man, you fucking build that climbing ladder. You got that REI son. You know what I'm saying?
That's true. I mean, I just think it's dangerous if it's still a crib child, Brendan.
Yeah,
you don't
I feel
want
you.
The fucking child, you know, getting out at night, getting into your shit, stealing. What else, dude? Oh, I was going to say this. I remember I made my sister a baby crib when we were children. And some kid had some wood. These born-again Christians around the corner from us had a little bit of extra wood. So I went over there every day, man, before Christmas. And just, I was like in there tinkering and tottering and doing this and that. And I made it for her, and I got it over there Christmas morning. She opened it up, and she got in it, bro, and literally
splinters.
Got splinters in her whole body. I hadn't sanded
it. That's what I'm talking about. I don't want those gifts from you. That's not your skill set, son. You have a different skill set. I don't want you building shit. Also, by extra wood, you mean the KKK members behind your house? Is that what you're talking about with extra wood, son?
These guys were religion only, bro. They had no...
Yeah, whatever, brother.
These guys were looking for the Lord no matter what color he was.
Ain't nobody
buying
that.
God, dude, I'm serious, man.
Yeah, maybe your sister maybe your sister didn't like her crib because it smelled like gasoline.
God, look, man. Maybe because it was made out of old pieces of burning crosses. That's why. But no, dude, I remember she got in it.
Maybe because it smelled like gasoline. It was covered in white sheets.
She couldn't get out, bro, because she got so many splinters right after she got in. Oh, it was horrible, man. But
yeah, dude, king it if you have a good skill set, bro.
Yeah,
and that thing looked king dope. It, shout out to that dad of the year there, man.
Yeah, there's something value about it. You know, you're going to be one of the only people doing that. Everybody, I'm not even joking. When I went to shop, there's only like four places to shop. It's just like it's all getting so narrow. So to be doing something creative, man, sky's the limit. Start with one for your kid, make one for the neighbor kid. My dad got me a wagon wheel when I was young. When my dad was born, they didn't have cars. So when he was a teenager, they didn't have cars, and he actually had a wagon.
Oh, shit.
And he had a wagon from his uncle used to make handmade wagons. And he actually had a wagon wheel that he gave me one time. It was autographed by his uncle.
And it was dope?
So it was good.
Man, fuck all that noise. Add that red flyer, that real shit. Not the some your uncle made in his backyard. Add that real fucking red flyer, son. The red fucking tin wagon. My brother carried me around in it. I'd fall out every now and then.
And your brother's still carrying you around, son.
Hell yeah.
Damn.
My brother built like Dana White. What else you got, Nick?
The people agree. 59% say king it. Here's the next one.
Amen, bro. Oh, who is this ISIS member? This dude is looking for a new group. That's for sure, man. I'm just joking, brother. Thank you for sending a video in.
Theo Brennan, my question for you guys today, bunk beds, y'all fuck with it? My lady friend, she puts her feet up here, that's dope, let me know, gang gang buzz buzz.
Bro, yeah, I fuck with them when I was 10, you can't be a grown man with bunk beds, that ain't cool, that's creepy, dude. Also, for kids, there's nothing better. Like, my son's as soon, my one son's gonna be 5 in February, the other one's gonna be, he just turned 1. Right when he turns about 2, my other son's 5, you get those little bitches bunk beds. They bunk up together, share stories at night. I don't have to go in there if somebody's scared. You get the bunk bed with the slide down. They can slide down. That shit's dope. Me and my brother grew up with bunk beds. But as a grown man, dude, you're out. Bunk beds, you're out. You know what I'm saying? You can't have bunk beds as a grown-ass man.
I mean, I think bunk beds is nice. Because your brother's close, it's like I like it because if you have a brother, y'all are in the same room. There's a little bit of distance.
Yeah.
You're not in the same bed, but you're close enough to hear each other breathe. Kind of. It's like being gay, kind of, but without all the freaking sex and everything.
Yeah, and you're still gonna be on the bottom no matter what. You feel me?
Nope. But what I do feel is I think it's great, man. My little nephews had bunk beds, man. Because here's the thing. You get two beds out of one bed space.
Yes. You got all
you
those
have a regular bed
activities.
And you have that air space.
Yes.
So, man, you got somebody you don't care about. You got somebody that's small. Put their little ass up there, you know.
Yeah, but this dude's talking about his girl sleeps on the top.
Yeah, dude, that's great. I don't want my freaking girl, my hot girlfriend, who's 98.6 degrees, fucking snuggling up to my ass like some kind of little fucking baby forest fire. Bitch, get upstairs. That's what I'm saying, dude.
You staying on the bottom bunk, huh?
Oh, I'm bottom
quick,
bunk
another
for life. I'm not climbing up there because it also, the ladder hurts the middle of my feet while I climb.
Ooh,
bro. I got
good call,
feet.
Bro. Good fucking call.
God,
I don't like
hurts,
those ladders
bro.
Either. The middle of your foot, there's nothing more sensitive than that middle foot. Ooh. It's tender. It's almost like veal. Yeah. You feel me?
Oh, it's like having a little dick hidden in the middle of, inside of each one of your foot.
Yeah, it's like your nutsack between your feet.
Yeah, dude. Bro, it's basically like the taint of your foot.
Yes.
I feel like that middle part.
Gotta be careful.
God. And you go up there and then you have to get down. Oof. Going up isn't as bad, but coming down and it's dark and you have to pee and you don't know what's going on. You don't know even what's real anymore.
Getting down when you have to pee is the absolute worst. Freshman year, you had the option. You could loft your beds or you could bunk them. My roommate like volunteered to take the top bunk so we could have more room. I came home after a weekend. I was gone and I came back and I laid in my bed and it was all wet. And I looked on the wall. This blackout drunk had thrown up in his top bunk and puked all down the side of my bed. I left. I was like, clean it or I'm going to kick your ass. And then when I came back, we lofted the beds.
Amateur hour, man.
No more bunk beds. Shout out Hunter Wisconsin. Fritz. Actually, very.
What's his name? Hunter Pence?
Hunter Fritz. Fritz.
Hunter Fritz, the old vomit.
Hunter Fritz?
Fritz.
Hunter Fritz?
Fritz, F-R-I-T-Z.
Sounds like he's going to try blowing up the ATT building.
He was actually pretty dope, though. He really contributed to my gambling addiction. He won like $100,000 in the beginning of freshman year, and then he bought my meals for the rest of the year because we didn't have service. So as long as I went to the quad where we could get service and ordered the delivery, I got to eat for free.
Oh, tight move.
It was awesome.
Legend. Shout out to the quad.
Good time.
And how's Hunter doing now? You think he would call in?
Yeah, I think Hunter would, definitely. He's doing like loans or mortgage loans. He cleaned it. He's got a regular job.
Let's call his bitch ass up. Okay, well, what's up with the bunk beds now, Hunter?
Yeah, and what happened with the gambling? I wonder how that went, like, overall, especially if you had that big win. What was the long-term effect of it?
Yeah, did you have a drug addiction after all that money?
No, we just smoked a lot of weed together.
That's drugs.
He was playing. That's drugs. He was playing, like, 12 hours a day, so.
He probably got a bunch of bitches being that rich in college, right?
I think he would, maybe if he was, like, he'd black out too fast. I think he could have, maybe, if he, like, ran a little game, kept himself under control. But.
Was he built like an armadillo? What did he look like?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. There you go. I knew what was going on there. I could tell you're beating around the bush there a little bit.
Yeah, he was a good guy.
Yeah, it's hard to fucking be unconscious at the same time, man. I'll say this, though. I think, what was this guy asking? If you can be upstairs? Oh, bunk beds.
Yeah, as grown men, you can't be in bunk beds, man. For kids, it's
dope. It does kind of take me back to a nice time. I do like the idea of it every now and then. I slept in it a couple nights during the Christmas holidays. It was good. But, yeah, I think it's weird. If you bring a lady home and you have bunk beds, it's going to be alarming.
Agreed. All right, let's move on to the next one. Another one from Dan. He sent in some great submissions, and these were all mine from the King of the Sting Facebook group. So go and join that, and you can submit your submissions there.
Hey, Brendan. Hey, Theo. This is Dan in Tampa again. Just wanted to go over a video that I saw about an orangutan kind of groping on this lady's frontal region. I don't know if that's illegal, if that's abuse and any sexual assault or something. I don't know how I felt about that, but what I want to know is how you feel about it. King it or sting it, that molesting monkey.
I mean,
look, I want to say that this LA Times writer is bullshit. A lot of these articles seem like they don't really come from anywhere, and there doesn't seem to be a lot of proof with any of this stuff.
Yeah.
So I haven't seen this guy. Like, I've never seen anything go down, but, you know, it just sounds like just kind of typical animalia behavior.
Yeah.
So I want to say
that.
And
also, this accusation of this orangutan is 21 years ago. I wasn't there. You know what I'm saying?
I think your boy's going down. We have video footage.
Oh, we got the actual video?
Shit. My bad.
Oh, I don't blame the orangutan, though. Oh, damn. Move on. Get her, orangutan.
Reaching for that beef, baby. Reaching for that front beef, huh?
Dang. That orangutan better stay out of L.A., tell you that much.
Orang-a-bang, bro. I wish that dude would freaking get loose in L.A., man. I'd love to see the New York Times write an article about that orangutan. He wouldn't give a fuck, bro.
He wouldn't give a fuck. Come at me,
and
bro.
And there's too many animal rights out here for him to get in trouble, too.
They say he had a pilot greenlit on Animal Planet, and they canceled it now.
They canceled it, yeah. Can he still podcast at least?
Only on Patreon.
Is Sam Tripoli his co-host?
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. Dude, that's crazy. I'm about to say the same joke for the first time in our lives in 101 episodes. We finally arrived at the same joke, dude. I cannot believe that our dads both are missing a fucking finger.
Same. Kingdom, they said. This monkey.
Oh, yeah, Kingdom. Bro, the last hope we have as a species is that animals strike back and start showing people what's what.
Yeah,
you know?
Planet of the Apes, dog.
Even this screenshot, he's like, check this out.
That orangutan's aggressive, bro.
But, dude, rumor is also that the girl had been sending messages to the orangutan on IG.
Yes.
So, it's a tough call, man.
I'm with the orangutan, though.
But here's
that
the thing.
Girl's hot, though. Let's just call it what it is.
Mm-hmm.
Very hot, man. And I think if you are, if we did evolve from animals, right? Like it says we did. But also people don't think that we did, and I'm not sure. But if it's if we did, animals are going to be pissed. When the animals look around the animal kingdom, they don't see any. There's no nice tits, bro. I've been to the zoo, dude. You know what I'm saying? Every now and then, maybe you see something that's got a nice fucking little baby bag hanging off.
Yeah, some of those gorillas are banging, though, Doug. Some of the asses on the baboons that get you going. You feel me?
No, keep going, bud.
No, keep going, Doug.
I want to see how this ends.
Oh, dude, check out the tits on this chimpanzee, though.
Okay, I'll agree. Not bad, okay? Not bad for some fucking woods titties. But I'm talking about if you bring those bitches to South Beach, dog, you ain't getting in the club, is what I'm saying.
Yeah,
okay?
That's right. You ain't getting the fountain blue with them saggy tits, I'll tell you that. Yeah, right,
dude,
now.
Yeah, you are, bro. With them fucking L cups, with them hairy L cups, you ain't getting shit, bro.
With them long L's?
Oh, dude. Those things only look good by firelight on freaking National Geographic television. So that's what I'm saying. A monkey probably, they're so used to seeing these trash bag titties around a zoo.
Yeah, that's a good call.
When they finally see a decent cup, you know, a cultured cup.
Yes.
Bro, you can't blame that monkey for finally.
First time
seeing
him.
That monkey's probably taking 1,000 pictures and finally he's reaching for a good cup.
Yep. I'm with the orangutan.
Word. Let's. Yeah. Next segment. We've got some relationship advice. We got some good ones this week.
Ooh. All right.
Okay. Nice, dude.
Brendan, Theo. What's up, boys? Big fan. Calling from Cincinnati, Ohio.
I can see the pain on his face.
I recently got over my kitty cat scratch foot fever, and I felt like it was time to get back out there, go on a date, and I need some dating advice. I went on a first date to an indoor rock climbing facility, and that was just sexual. And anyway, the date was great. She's super cool, way cooler than me, and
oh, yeah,
I like her
a lot. Upskirt.
But I found out that she was 28, and I am only 21. How do you boys feel? Let me know. Should I keep it going? Is it too much? Thanks, Kat. I love you. Gang, buzz, buzz.
Gang, bro.
Damn, bro. Only 28, though. I thought he was going to say she's 38 or 48. 28? You
or
21?
58, yeah.
Who gives a fuck, dude? Keep climbing them rocks.
Yeah, dude. You want to climb up. You want to have sex upward. You don't want to be banging downward.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? That gets you in trouble. If you're hitting us up saying, look, this girl's 16, this girl's 9, you're going to jail, buddy.
Yeah, we can't have you on the show, bro.
But you're within a legal range where you're legally allowed to make moves on that one.
What's the oldest chick you've hooked up with, Theo?
Probably maybe 46. 46.
Okay. All right.
What about yourself, man?
42, probably.
Liar.
That's wild.
42?
But look, man. What about you, Nick? Hold on. Nick is definitely going to trump us both.
Yeah.
Mid-50s, but I'm shocked that you guys.
God. Dog. Mid-50s?
50s, bro?
You fucked a
are
golden girl?
Oh, damn, bro. Bro, are you talking about a Jimmy Carter supporter?
Dude, you talking about a Richard Nixon fan?
Yeah, dude, sign my wagon wheel, bro. Are you out of your mind?
Dude, this woman, she animated, I'm probably going to out her, you probably figure it out, but she animated on Who Framed Roger Rabbit. She was like, dude.
You're not outing anybody.
Yeah. Yeah, nobody's like, wait, is that Betty Sue?
Or was that her friend? And she also animated Kung Fu Panda. I met her while I was driving for Uber.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
I met her. I picked up her and this, it was a two older women and a guy. And they were taking the guy out because he was going through a divorce. And mm-hmm. they dropped him off and they were like, they're really fun. And I always got asked out when I was Ubering. People would be like, oh, come hang out. But most of the time, like, the clock was running. I had to drive so many hours till Sunday to make rent. But I finally had a little bit of cushion. So I was like, okay, I'll come out, have a drink. And everything got crazy. Those other two hooked up in her downstairs, and I hooked up with her for a couple months.
How'd it go down? She was like, let's go upstairs, young man.
First, we went to the bar for like hours. And then when we were done, we were like, oh, let's all go to Irene's house.
And then she was like, take this fucking cardigan off. Let's do this.
And then she
let's
just
get these L tits out.
And then one day she was just like, this is done. And I was like, okay.
Why was it done? She didn't like your attitude?
I don't know. I she said she got in a real relationship, and I was like, okay, if he dies, hit me up.
Oh.
Wow.
Sorry, Jules.
And do you still communicate with her, Nick?
No. You throw some lines out like months later, see what, and just no response. So yeah.
What do you mean throwing lines out? Like you text like, "Hey, you still alive?"
Just hey, what's going on to like whoever you used to hook up with?
Hey, how was your nap?
Hey, you want to do dinner? It's 3:45 p.m. You text them. Dude, that's crazy, man. That woman was still. Let me see. God. 18 years younger than my dad when I was born. So, that old Nick.
Was she like a banging 55-year-old though?
She was really good looking. She was redhead Canadian. But
sounds but, awful.
Yeah. And she had all 10 of her fingers.
Okay. Ooh. All right. You didn't have to go there. That's a low
blow.
But
the crazy thing is, from bro, in old generations, that was a big thing. If you showed up to the table, 10 fingers, 10 toes, man, that was. I mean, you were basically the Robert Redford of your community.
Also, redhead, you're the Paul Newman of that bitch. You're killing it.
But back to this guy. And I don't think you should be worried about the age as much as the rock climbing. I don't like doing activities on dates. That could get exhausting after a while. She wants to go camping. She wants to go rock climbing.
It's not a bad
what's
first
next?
Date. You get to see her climb up the mountain, some Daisy Dukes.
A lot of upskirt, man. I think that's big upskirt country if you get over there. An upskirt is people that's real, real lonely and probably are going to go to jail taking pictures of people's crotches when they don't know it.
Fair.
And
he shouldn't be worried, though. That ain't shit, dude.
Stick with it. Go on a second date.
Definitely stick with it.
Cool. We got to.
Yeah, go on a second date, man. You're a child, dude. You're lucky that this woman will even spend time with you.
Agree.
We got another relationship
advice. Gang, gang, bro.
This one might be near and dear to Brendan's heart.
How's it going, Brendan, Theo? Got a quick question for you, relationship advice. As I'm wearing that merchy merch, is it worth it, that hot passion Latina love, when they're out here doing things like this? Ooh, breaking everything I love. That's my Xbox and guitars. But then, after the storm, comes the love.
Yes.
4 days later, she bought me a brand new Xbox. Wow. Is it worth it? That crazy love when 1 second everything you love and own is broken and shattered. But then come sweet kisses, love, and passion like never before. Is it worth it? Let me know, y'all. Love you guys. Gang, gang. Buzz, buzz.
Yeah, that's a fake King of Sting shirt, but whatever. Listen, man, I'd have to see the Latina, though, because you it's worth it. You got to walk through some fire to get through the storm, you feel me? And the sun always comes out after a storm. Usually it's worth it. If they're bad enough, stick with it, my man.
Yeah, Brennan's also trying to save his marriage, so he's saying that. But what I'm going to say is this, dude. What I'm going to say is this, bro. This is the beginning of how this is going to be a very peligroso, dangerous, bro. Environment. Like, I admire any man. I admire Brendan. I admire Cesar Chavez's wife. Any man that is willing to take on Latina woman, because they are dangerous, bro. They're vatas, dude. A lot of them, they sleep at night, but barely, you know. They're fucking just in their mind, they're awake doing fucking tattoo art and shit. They just, you know, they're very dangerous. And this is the beginning of things getting smashed. She's going to smash your bank account. She's going to smash 5 kids in your life, dude. 4 kids.
At least. Nah, dog.
You know,
Some Flaming Hot Cheetos and a dick suck. There ain't nothing better, dude. Keep riding this out, and it's worth it, man. End of this Latino
rainbow. Especially if they're in that. Especially if they're in that order, too. I want to say
that's
that.
That's what I'm saying, bro.
Oh, damn.
Stick with it, dog.
I'm just a little worried about that dog. He said everything he loves. That might be next if they get in.
That's the price you got to pay, dude, to get with a Latina. If she's bad enough, you're going to sacrifice that little hound. You feel me, cabrón?
Yeah, man. The mono that rocks the cradle, papa. You feel me?
So those were good relationship advices. Keep sending those in. Those are fun.
Yeah, dude, look, invite us to your funeral. Also, please write down somewhere on your nightstand or whatever, if you come up missing, that we get to go to your funeral. I think that'd be awesome field trip for us, man.
Yeah, also ask your girl to film it if she does murder you. King or sting it, murder my white boyfriend.
Or film anything and send it to us, dude. I'm fucking lonesome. You know what I'm saying, dude? And in my city, lonely guys are fucking killing themselves. How about that bomber at the fucking downtown Nashville?
Sting it.
Some lonely dude in a camper. I thought it was Ari Manis, bro, at first. I thought it was.
Yeah, he tried getting rid of 5G.
Is Ari living in Nashville in his camper?
No, but I'm sure he will be soon, man.
So that does it for relationship advice. Let's move on to Rip My Drip. We haven't done that for a while. This guy.
Is Chin here today? Is Chin here? Oh, damn. He'll be back tomorrow, though.
They always come back. This is, and he wrote this. This is Chris Chaos 420. He's a teacher assistant at an elementary school for 8 years. He's vaping, quote unquote, CBD for stress occasionally throughout the day. And he has a podcast called the Friday Podcast. Friday Podcast. Used to be a rapper, but now has been recording new songs. He's a single dad, 31 years old, with a 12-year-old.
Oof.
Munches on the school lunch and breakfast meals. Gets to kick it with pre-K to 5th-grade kids and gets to talk about Marvel, Pokemon, Dragon Ball Z, and other dope stuff. Always keeping it rated G at work, except when I'm flirting with another teacher and no kids are around.
Oh, damn, daddy.
Gang, gang.
Don't hurt him. He wants to rip his drip.
Yeah.
So he knows what he signed up for. He looks like he sweats when he watched Nickelodeon.
Bro, he looks like the last boss you have to fight at In-N-Out Burger.
He looks like he's about to get fired.
Yeah, he does. Yeah, it looks like when the school sees this, he's gonna be out of a job. It looks like he's gonna be driving for Uber, fucking 55-year-olds.
Yeah, bro,
not a bad gig. You look like you're.
What'd you say, Nick?
Just that's not a bad gig if you can get it Ubering 55-year-olds.
It's not. Oh yeah, that's not a bad gig, dude. Bro, this guy reminds me of this dude, Mr. Vliet, bro, that went to my school. He was a Spanish teacher, and he would have no idea what was going on all year. And then at the end of the year, you literally, if you brought in like anything that was Mexican, a Spanish casserole, a Mexican friend, a picture of a Mexican, he'd give you 70,000 bonus points. He'd be like, oh, you brought in 2 taquitos? You got 20,000 bonus points. And one of my best friends saw him in the bathroom during school one day, and my buddy was getting a D, and he fucking threatened him right there at the urinal. And he goes, "If you fucking give me a D, I'm gonna rat you out. I'm gonna tell everybody what you're doing with your million bonus points for casseroles. Like, that's insane." And the guy gave him a freaking B.
Oh,
man.
Damn! Well, he's also gonna lose his job if he's still there.
But this guy, man, yeah, look, I think if you're not pedophiling and you're doing regular and you're being an adult, man, I respect that. A lot of people can't be around kids and not be a pedophile.
Yeah, facts. Also, if you're around kids that long, you got to get high. So I'm not mad at this dude sneaking into the janitor's closet, smoking a little reefer during his off time, during 5th period, getting high with the other teachers. I'm not mad at
you. Gramming up, bro. Do your thing, man.
Yeah, do your thing,
and especially
daddy.
If you're hollering at those other bait. Dude, there's nothing sexier, I don't think, than hooking up with a teacher, man.
Preach. Like when that when those scandals come out that this hot teacher hooked up with two students at the same time, where the fuck was this happening when I was in school? My teachers looked like shit.
Yeah, that was a problem. They,
yeah, my teachers looked like warlocks. They didn't have a chance with us.
I'm sure one of them had a chance with you. Who was the one that had a chance?
Probably Mr. Decker.
Our Spanish 5 teacher, and she dated a senior for like, and I was in love with her actually, and then I found out after
that she was only 24.
She was only like 26 or something, but yeah, they dated all throughout his senior year, and like all the kids knew, but somehow the school didn't find, and then they continued to date after. And when I found out about that, it broke my heart because it was like I was in freshman, and I was like I could have had a chance.
What a real love story! You think they're still together?
Wow. I don't think they are.
We should have them call in.
Yeah, I almost said her name. But.
Yeah, she probably got fired as well.
I think she.
Dude, I'll tell you straight up, Miss Garofola, I think was our lady's name. She taught math, dude, or something. I don't even. No, right when I got into her class, I was so freaking just erect the whole time. I don't know what she was teaching, dude. I don't know if she was teaching math. I don't even know if she worked at our school, dude. All the blood would just run to different ends of my body, dude. And she wore like perfume or cologne or something. It was good, bro.
Let's move on to some debate club. And this guy is, he's got an appropriate one.
What up, y'all? It's your boy, Fro Bob Long Pants. Out here with a debate club for y'all boys, because I seen the post. I seen y'all needed some help. So I got a debate club for y'all, bro.
Robot.
Since it's the New Year's coming up, you feel me? What would y'all rather do? Go out to the clubs and to the bars and all that for New Year's? Or do like a little kickback function kind of deal at the crib with some friends and, you know, y'all just drink at the crib and do that.
Friends, bro, you better get some tits out there, dog. Yeah,
I need to know.
Tits in your face for the New Year's.
Gang.
Listen,
Ian's funny. Ian's funny.
All right.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Hey, nigga, fade, bro. Look. I'm high. I'm smoking marijuana.
Okay, he's high on that kush, man. He's hopped up.
Like, it's all, we're in L.A., son. It's everywhere out here. Bro, what I would do for New Year's, I'd go to Palm Beach Improv. That's what I would do because I'll be in that bitch. But if I'm not working, I'm at home, bro. And I'm not even awake when that ball fucking drops. I can't tell you the last time I was awake when that, probably when we did the fucking Comedy Store thing. Other than that,
dude, your ball.
I'm asleep by 10, bro. I don't give a fuck about that ball dropping. Everyone watches Cooper bring you into the fucking New Year. I'm not about that life. People blowing RVs up and shit. I'm trying to be my undies, watching reruns of First 48.
Oh yeah, it's good. I hate to say how it ends, but a black guy kills everybody.
And they're always in Oklahoma.
It's always the worst. It's always. Like some, Tulsa. The guy never knew why'd you do it, Scoops? And the guy's like, oh no, man.
And they're always ratting on each other. You realize cops can't do shit without snitches.
Yeah.
You realize they're not very good at their job. They have no evidence, no fingerprints. It's always snitches that solve the case.
It really is, dude.
Every episode.
Fingerprints isn't even a thing anymore.
No,
bro.
Every episode.
If they see fingerprints, they will wash them off of the crime scene.
Yeah, because they know someone's going to snitch.
That's crazy, man. It's just different, man. It's just, yeah, why'd you do it, Scoops? I don't know.
What you doing for New Year's, Theo?
Well, look, first of all, I want to say this, man. Thanks for the submission, young brother. And I know it's, you know, and I'm going to go out on a short limb, and say this guy's obviously a mixed gentleman. And that's really where it is. The power today is really with the mixed gentleman. You know, you see it with Patrick Mahomes, with, who else, man? Yeah, The Weeknd, it's everywhere. So what I'm saying is this, man, I don't think going out to a club, first of all, you got to go to the club. It's going to be loud. The music hasn't even been that great this year. So you have to be listening to all of that shit. Then you got to convince a woman, if you like women, to come back to your house or, you know, COVID pad. It's just too much, man. So I think you do a small get together, maybe smoke a little bit of the lamb's wool, baby. You know what I'm saying? That freaking, the tuft. Of the Lord, baby, that dank, that dank,
dank,
and
dank.
And then, yeah, man, and just chill out, man. Jerk off or hug somebody and jerk off, bro. Woman.
Yeah, but don't bring the New Year's in crying.
No. No, no, no.
Which gets me back to you. What are you doing for New Year's?
Oh, yeah, dude. You really skirted that question.
Yeah.
I actually scheduled my last cry session of the year is December 29th.
Smart man.
So, what am I doing? I don't know, man.
Sounds like you have
I haven't
no
thought
plans.
Of anything.
Yeah, sounds like you have no plans.
I have no plans. I'll probably see if anybody's having a party or something, but I don't know anybody that is. So I will probably just relax, get a nice pizza.
Ooh, a nice maybe cheese pizza to yourself.
Yeah, dude, get a cheese
Macaulay
pizza
Culkin
maybe.
Style.
Make some breadsticks, maybe make 10 breadsticks and break one of them in half in honor of my father.
Fuck yeah, honor of my dad too, man. Go and dip that bitch in that sauce for me.
Oh, yeah, 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 I will. And, yeah, I don't have big plans. What are you guys going to do?
I'm at Palm Beach Improv.
Oh, yeah, there we go again. I forgot.
Yeah, Palm Beach Improv again. I'll be in Florida, man. Bring New Year's in Florida.
That. Is it Thursday night? Is that it?
When this premieres at 9 p.m. Pacific, the ball just have dropped in New York. And then people will watch us.
Happy New Year's.
Yeah, Happy New Year's.
Damn, I didn't even know New Year's is Thursday. Hell yeah.
And thank you for coming to the live. You know, I like to jump in the premiere every now and then and see what's going on. Brendan doesn't have a YouTube account, so hard to get him in there.
I'm working on it, man. It's coming.
But thank you guys, man.
We'll have to go out with some New Year's music when we wrap this up. But we got one more debate club, and then we'll see some of these Culture Corner auditions. This is Nick from Wisconsin.
Nick with the Mr. Blue Eyes.
What's up, guys? This is Nick from Wisconsin. I got a debate club for you. Who's the better faker, Rachel Dolezal or Hilaria Baldwin? Gang, gang, buzz, buzz.
Dude, and that Hilaria Baldwin's getting tore the fuck up. Now her, speaking of snitches, now her classmates are sending old pictures of her when she said she was in Spain. Shows her in fucking Boston in high school, some school play. She's just getting outed. I don't get why she was trying to pretend she was from fucking Spain. What's the point? Just be from fucking Boston. Who gives a fuck?
Have you seen this, Theo?
I don't know about this.
Oh, you don't know about this, bro? She's getting lit up right now. She's Alec Baldwin's wife, and she would go on like the Today Show. She was a correspondent for Extra, but she would go on the Today Show, and she would give like this weird Spanish accent. And she was like, in your culture, you say cucumber. You say cucumber. And then you realize she's just a white girl from Boston.
She was literally like, she's this year's Rachel Dolezal. She's been acting like she's been Spanish speaking for, and she's from Western Massachusetts or something.
Yeah. I'd say that Rachel Dozak's way worse. She was the head of the NAACP or NAAA, whatever the fuck it is.
NAACP.
Bro, she was basically the ovary MLK, bro.
For real.
I thought Dolezal was dope. She was trying to do good stuff for black people. She was just trying to be involved. She was basically just Woe Vicky, but 15 years older.
she was older Woe Vicky and just dyed her skin all black, though. But she was doing good shit. She was really helping them out, and then they fucking kicked her out of the club.
Yeah, it's like kind of like that's the thing. Sometimes you just got to – look, if people are helping, you keep them involved, man. You know? It's like – I don't know.
At least Rachel was doing the Lord's work and trying to help black people out. This lady's just stealing the fucking culture of Spanish people for no reason.
But check this out, Theo. Here's a...
Oh, this is the clip? I mean, so what happens with her? It's not like, what's she gonna, can she still podcast? Probably Patreon only.
Yeah, at this point. And she's a real person?
Yeah.
Real white person.
Oh, the Hillary Baldwin Cucumber pretends to be Spanish. That's the video you're looking for. You see it?
Oh, yes.
That's it. That's the one I saw. She really went over the top.
Did she?
Yeah. Listen, I don't think I don't know where you're going to cancel her from. She's just a mom.
We have very few ingredients. We have tomatoes. We have, how do you say it? Cucumber?
Cucumbers.
We have red pepper. We have, of course, the...
And there's millions of examples. She said, like, she's been asked point blank, and she's like, oh, my family is from Spain, but they were like vacationing there, and she made it sound like they were there till she was 18. Just senseless, really. I don't know what she's getting out of it.
Yeah, I just don't get why she does it. Like, what's the point? What's the narrative? No one's like, oh, she's from Spain? Let's give her a fucking job with E. I don't get it.
But who cares? Here's the thing. Especially now we got Ancestry 6. What is it? Ancestry 60?
Ancestry.com. You got 21andMe. You got 13 Ways to Die. Listen, yeah. Theo pretends he's a straight male. We don't cancel him.
Oh, come on, man. Dude, I've definitely spent more time with women than you have, bro. Let's be honest, dude.
Next week's King of the Sting guest host, Tim Dillon, tweeted, Hilaria Baldwin was just picked up by ICE.
Dude, but here's what I'm saying. With Ancestry.com and Ancestry, you know, whatever it is, Ancestry 60, they're doing now where everybody has a little bit of everything in them. So what's to say in this woman's life that, you know, the 9% of Spanish flared up for a half a decade?
That's
you
fair.
Know what I'm saying? You can't really, you know, if you're wanting people to be everything, then let them be what they want to be, man.
And that's my thing.
It's
who
like
gives
everybody has
fuck?
Freedom of self-expression.
Yeah, if she wants to talk like she's from Spain, you're right.
Yeah.
Do it. It's stupid, but do it. Who gives a fuck?
Yeah, I find it, like, interesting and funny, but the people who are getting really upset, like, she's, like, appropriating culture, who gives
hilarious.
A shit? Who gives a shit? Have you seen Mackenzie Dern, that her...
Brazilian
that,
accent?
Yeah,
yeah,
evolution.
I don't care. Yeah. I don't care. She's hot as fuck.
Dude, how about those Buffalo Bills pulling it off last night?
Bro, you ain't from Buffalo.
Dog, but they're good, bro. You imagine just the suppression, the repression, bro. That they went through for 20 years in that division.
Listen, I was on the Buffalo Bills for about 8 days, and I know what they went through. I was there for 8 days. I had a cappuccino.
Who was quarterback when you were there?
I had a cappuccino with the Buffalo Bills. The quarterback was J.P. Lozman.
No way, was it really?
Yeah.
They're boys.
I used to party with J.P. down in New Orleans.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, he went to Tulane, right?
Yeah, he went to Tulane, man. I still have his freaking jersey at home.
Oh, you should wear that bitch. There's no Schaub jersey. I wasn't on the team long enough. They gave me a jersey without a name on it. And then I knew.
You'll have Willie McGinnis, huh?
I knew I was cut when I saw another guy who was a first-round draft pick with the same number.
Ooh. What's it
called? NFL teams don't have double numbers. So I knew my time was short. I'll tell you what was tough, coming back to my nine-finger father while he had a Buffalo Bills flag on the house and I got cut.
No way.
Oh, dude, it was so embarrassing.
He put a Bills flag out
there? Yeah, and all the neighbors were like, oh, we're Buffalo Bills fans now, and there's like all this shit on the house. And my dad had this giant Buffalo Bills flag outside the house. Came back,
he had
fucking
a Scott Norwood statue in the yard.
Dog, I came back 9 days later.
But did you cross
paths? 9 days. One day for each finger your dad had.
For reals.
Did you cross paths with the original Antonio Cromartie, Travis Henry? He had like 9 kids out of wedlock.
13, bro.
Travis Henry had 13? Cromartie.
Cromartie, 13.
Yeah, Travis Henry's putting up some numbers too.
Yeah.
Was he on the team at the time?
I forget.
Probably around there. Should we close out with some Culture Corner additions?
Yeah, what do we got, Doug?
What about the audition? Yeah, let's get to see these auditions, man. I want to see who's ready for this.
My name is Alex Hernandez-Diaz, and here's 5 reasons of why I should be in the Culture Corner. 1, I'm not a predator. 2, I'm not a racist. 3, I'm Mexican as fuck, bro. 4, I'm extremely reliable. I have my own car. And 5, I'm a cheesehead. Come on, Nick. Watch out. I got that Brett Favre hitter, Holmes. I'm also an editor and have a YouTube channel with over 10,000 subscribers to show for it, which means that I can edit for you guys, make clips and things of that nature. I'm also a big fan of each and every single one of you, and I respect the hell out of all of you too. And thanks to all of you for making us laugh. Oh, and did I mention that I'm fluent in Spanish? Theo y Brendan son muy chistosos. Anyways, that's my time. I'm Alex the Mexican, and I need a beer.
Yo, Ma, can I get a cerveza?
All right, I'm not mad at him. Now, is he local? Is he in LA? If he's a cheesehead, that's a little weird to be a cheesehead in LA, yeah?
And it's queso de cabeza, actually.
I think he said in Spanish, Theo and Brendan are muy caliente.
I prefer fimales.
And Brendan keep prefers, lying to yourself. Keep like your shirt says otherwise.
That seemed more like a. Go ahead.
And Brendan prefers tamales.
Your friend Joe Exotic says otherwise.
Oh, dude. Please. Donald Trump, please pardon Joe Exotic.
I agree.
Dude.
Before you leave, man, get that man out of prison so we get fucking Tiger King 2 up in this bitch. I need something to watch.
Please. Look, I like this guy's attitude. Some of the stuff that he loved all of us, that sounds hard to believe sometimes when people say, like, just group love like that. But I did like his attitude. He only has, like, a minute or something to really get his point across. I love the fact also that he is willing to work after he gets off of the clock to help out with editing.
Yeah. That was more of a control room audition, I think, than culture core.
He seemed good at it. That was the best submission we've had as far as quality and editing. By far the best.
Yeah,
best production.
That's a good point. Yeah, I wonder where he lives at now. He did seem like control room editor. Maybe there's something there.
Yeah, I actually did find it. He's from San Diego. So.
Okay, he can move. And look, if he's really 100% Mexican, dude, he'll keep heading this way anyway.
Yeah, he's going to be up here anyway, yeah. Selling coconuts.
Yeah. Let's see what this guy has to say. Ian.
What's up, King? This thing. My name's Ian Callahan, and this is why I should be in the culture.
Apparently, got a chain for Theo.
White boy. I live in L.A. right on Pico Robertson, right next to all of the Hebrew or Orthodox Jew, however you want to call it. So that's the culture right there. I am a convicted felon, so we can talk about that. Ooh. That is culture in itself. Bro. That's prison culture, baby.
You're out, brother.
And let's not forget that I do have a rap song called Had to Pull Them Titties Out. I dropped when I was 18 years old, and it is an absolute banger. And we have some Asian Christmas dancers dancing in it, and I will put the link in this email so you can check it out, Nick. But I think it would be a great time, and I'd love to join Gang Gang Buzz Buzz Culture Culture.
Okay, convicted felon. Usually that's frowned upon, but we're equal employers here.
Oh, yeah. Nick went to jail, didn't you, Nick?
I have never been to jail.
You've never been to jail?
Nope.
That's surprising.
I know. I wonder if we just put on the IG, do you think Nick has been to jail or not, what people would vote?
80%.
Yeah, I think it'd be pretty high. I'll put it up. I'm trying to find this guy's email. See if he's. Do we want to watch?
I would love to see it. Yeah, I would.
Drop Them Titties Out.
Yeah, Drop Them Titties. Sounds like a banger. Don't say banger, though, because we've never heard of it, though, you know?
I bet Brendan didn't. Weren't you in that Nelly video, Brendan? What were you in?
MC Hammer.
So crazy.
Don't disrespect me. Nelly, come on. MC Hammer, bro. You were in, what's that chica's name?
Bad Barbie.
That's right. That was dope.
This is, Had to Pull Them Titties Out, the music video.
Young Klepto. Had to pull them titties.
Young Klepto.
Looks like my dad.
Amen, baby. That's Ravishing Rick Rude, baby.
May he rest in peace.
I'm about to get my titties out.
This video is kind of chatty.
Yeah, it's a bit too long of an intro.
Yeah.
Ooh, bunch of cats. Looks like they're performing this at a local high school.
Oh, yeah. This looks like one of those Japanese mental health facilities, kind of.
I've seen a lot of Bukkake videos that start like this.
I haven't seen any of that. Okay, I'm good here.
Ah, had to pull them titties.
Thank you, Jonathan. What's your guy's name? Is Jonathan? Titties.
What do we think of Ian, the convicted felon?
Ian.
We've had some good submissions. I'm not mad at the banger, not mad at the title, Pull Them Titties Out, but... Mm. I don't know. We've had some good ones, man. I don't know if we need another white person in here. I don't want to get sued.
That's the tricky part these days, especially, you know. And look, I love what you did, man. I love your work. I love the fact you've been in jail. You know, you made it out.
I like that you like titties. We could use another straight male in here.
Yeah, we probably could, man. I like the costumed Viettes. You know, that's one of my favorite thing, bro. It's easy to get some Asians, but also to dress them up. What else, man? I like your style. I think maybe check back with us in a month.
That's fair.
When he's off parole.
Yeah. Ooh, who's this baddie, though?
Hey, Brandon. What's up, Theo? It is Abby from San Francisco.
She said my name
and
first.
I am submitting to be in your guys' culture corner. After COVID hit, I moved back down to L.A., and I thought I could bring my Ashkenazi schnozzy to your guys' studio and finally get a Jew's point of view on The King and the Sting. Theo, that hitter of a nose was fooling us for a little bit, but I think the viewers are catching on. And for the sanctity of your guys' podcast, Running Out of Hollywood, I think it's about time you guys get a chosen one on the show.
Fair point.
And sorry, but usually when you get us involved, good things do happen. Just fair saying. I'm also born and raised in the mecca of all things woke and dope. So in today's society, I think it's good for me to be well-versed in Nancy Pelosi's satanic Bible and Governor Newsom's spark notes on how to ruin a society. Fortunately, they run the district that I call home. And part of the reason why our comedy scene is completely dead, but that's okay. I'm submitting to be on your guys' show. And if you guys want me there, Theo, just like feather your mullet and Brendan, click your off-white collabs 3 times. I'll be there for you boys, okay? Gang, gang, Shabbat, shalom, my Jews.
Amen, player. Nice. Thank you, miss.
She called it. These are the new off-white collab. I like this there young you. Lady. I like this young smart. Lady. Listen, she looks like Halsey, all right? She looks a little bit like Halsey, and I think she could be a good addition. And I think her and Theo have the exact same nose, okay? And I think she looks like Theo's sister, and I think she'd be a great addition to the Culture Corner. Let's get Jewy up here, Theo.
First of all, Brennan, I just got my sister a nice gold chain that I gave to her at a Waffle House the other night where the cook had just quit when we got there. And we didn't know, and we ordered. And the lady there, she's like, can't you fucking see we don't have a cook? Like, no, bitch,
no,
I can't.
No, bitch. Bring us our goddamn chicken.
Can't see that. Yeah, cannot see that. That's fine, but fucking you should put a sign on the door, okay? So, anyway, quite a time over there at the Baton Rouge Waffle.
Does she not look like Halsey?
Halsey's also Jewish, though, Brennan, so I think you're just Jew.
Halsey's also half black. Do you know that? Her dad's black.
Judifying.
We've got another submission.
I like the Jew girl, though. For the record, I like the Jew girl. I think she'd be a fun addition. And I clap my heels 3 times, and I get new off-whites on. Ooh! Look, who's this little
is
queen?
Is that Halsey?
Hey, Cats family. Alicia here. Merry Christmas. I am submitting a video today to come and hang out with you guys in the Culture Corner. I would love to come and be a part of the Culture Corner. I do live in Southern California area. I submitted a video a while ago for Wed Better Dead, episode 18, and I am on there. So you can check me out there. That's it. I hope you all are doing well. Happy New Year. Gang, gang, buzz, buzz, culture, culture. Love y'all.
Buzz, bye. Buzz, young queen. The thing is she's so friendly. If her and Chappelle had a kid, the world would be right. They're just too friendly, you know?
But she's also in within 1 minute. That's the thing. What side of yourself do you show? You know what I'm saying? If you have 1 minute to show people something, do you show them 9 of your fingers or that you're missing a finger?
You show that you're missing a finger, like, off the bat, son. You come with that heat. Like that Jew girl came with the heat off the bat, cracking some jokes, some Pelosi jokes, some Newsom jokes.
Yeah. It's hard to know what to have. Like if there's any real, there's no real criteria.
She made fun of your nose, which I liked.
Yeah, well, that's easy to do.
This is.
But look, yeah, both these ladies, I think. I mean, look, this is the first I'm seeing of the videos, so I think we'll have to think about
here's
it.
Here's
right?
The other thing, too. We could rotate random guests until we find one that fits. If there's chemistry, you can rotate through them.
Yeah, the audition tape's just step one.
Yeah, that's just step one. We bring them in, cool, thanks for trying out. Bring in another one, thanks for trying. Then maybe sometime next year we make a final decision.
Next year, Brendan.
Like mid next year, mid 2021.
Mid Mid next year, these people could go on with their lives. They could be married.
Yeah, maybe.
I don't think it means a year from now. I think it means a couple days.
Yeah, exactly. Thursday's okay. Next year, Woogie.
Okay. Here is hands down.
It's Wigger.
No, Woogie.
You looked the wrong way.
Oh, sorry. It's Wigger, dog.
All right. Here's hands down the weirdest one we've received so far.
Soy Ángel. Actualmente estoy en San Jacinto, California.
Hi.
That's me on the left. You see, these hands can also make eye babies. So if you guys would allow me on, it would be greatly appreciated.
They guys need some help. Listen, betterhelp.com, promo code CATS. Everybody needs help.
Look, first of all, young man, thank you very much for sending that in, bro. That's a beautiful piece of art, I think.
Yeah, you full of shit and you're scared. Listen, I'm going to call it what it is. That thing was creepy, bro. Maybe resend something in that we can use, you know? God. And listen, I don't want no problems. I don't want no problems. Don't pull up my house in an RV with explosives. I want no problems.
Brendan, no problem, Shaw over there. I want the fucking smoke, white boy, okay? Or whatever that guy might have been, semi-white.
I think I was Latino.
I say bring it, bro. Bring it over here. King of the Sing Studios. Bring it out here to Calabasas. Bring it to freaking B. Shaw's house. And let's do this shit, bro.
Gang.
Bring your guns. Bring your anthrax. Let's go.
Yeah, we can get saucy if you want, bro. I'll roll up these sleeves. Is that it, Nick?
That's it. That was fun.
I think that girl's the best submission.
I think the ladies have taken the lead, I think.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But I look forward to figuring that out and thinking about it a little bit more.
Well, Happy New Year, man.
Yeah, man. Happy New
2020,
Year.
2020, tough year. Let's call it like it is. Tough fucking year for your boys here. But we made it through. Yeah. We're getting through. 2021's going to be big. It's going to be fun. Hopefully the world mm-hmm. opens back up. I'll be at Palm Beach Improv Thursday, Friday, Saturday, me and the crew. All right, San Marcos, mm-hmm. Texas after that. And I'm just looking forward to starting a new year, man. 2020 was really tough.
Brendan, I think you have to change your mentality, man.
Okay, go on.
That's it.
Thanks, man. That really helped. It. Yeah, thank you.
Again,
it's betterhelp.com, promo code CATS.
You got to come into this year blazing, bro. Get your guns blazing.
You right?
You know, I think it's a big year for you to really shine, bro.
Thanks, brother. You too, man.
I wouldn't mind seeing you get back into Bellator either.
All right. Not the direction I thought we were going to go. But.
Just saying, man. I'll corner you if you get in there.
No, you should fight Jake Paul.
Oh, dude. Bro, I will beat the remaining hair that is in that guy's head out. What else we got?
That's it, brother.
That's it. Oh, I will be January 15th. I have a live show. It's pay-per-view. It's January 15th, 8 p.m. Eastern. You can buy a ticket now. And that's going to be it. It's a belated Christmas talent show. There's going to be some live performances. Everything is going to be it's going to be dope. So look forward to you guys being there. We'll put a link below for that and a link below for Brendan's shows in West Palm Beach.
That'd be cool, man. Looking forward to it, brother.
Happy New Year to everybody that supports King and the Sting, and thanks for being a part of our lives.
Yeah, we love you guys, man. 2020, see ya. 2021,
gang,
coming
gang.
In hot.
Brendan and Theo, fighter in wait. I gotta go in and go hard in the paint. I do not think, I am in flow. Black Rifle Coffee, I'm ready to go. I need a sponsor, I am a monster. About to open up with this at my concerts. Flow is contagious, brows are outrageous. Thicker than girls that are Instagram famous. Damn, hungry like I'm fresh off keto. Seeing red like Andrew Santino. Every song I hit like the great Bambino. Brendan ate the queso and the queso Ritos. But everything's gonna be fine. Hate on me, I do not mind. Theo looking like the type of dude that got a pack
stack of matches in his pockets at all times. They sliding into my DMs. A couple of you tried but couldn't beat them. Quit playing like Nintendo DS. You don't want the smoke like Joey Diaz. Meaning y'all edible. Just got my eyebrows threaded and I'm feeling incredible. Brennan's son hit me up. He said it's too loud in the club. Can you pick me up? King and the Sting. King and the Sting.
Oh yeah.
On a string. Oh, yeah.